Hi, I'm Helena here, and the BookTube-a-thon day 5, pretty sure that's right, is upon us. And the video challenge is to do a kind of a reading list for a subject, kind of like you're a teacher assigning a reading list, and then what subject is it? What books would you assign, and then how, for a little extra of a challenge if you want to pick out one of the books that is on your TBR to kind of mix it in with this challenge, like to see if you can add one. Yeah, so I have quite a few. I have 11 books to talk about, so I'm going to try to go through them quickly and then do a quick update. And one of them actually does tie in from the book that I'm currently reading with this, so let's get started. Alright, so the subject that I chose was not, like, as broad of a subject as just LGBT books, but, kind of, not exactly coming out stories either, kind of becoming comfortable with your sexuality. Like, LGBT books that kind of focus on that, or that have a big arc of that somewhere in them. So the first one that I have here that I'm going to talk about real quick, because I was going to get the preview on my Kindle to show the cover, but I didn't like that cover because it's different from the one I have and I've read, and that is Between Lovers by Eric Jerome Dickey. And this one is about a bisexual woman, a woman who leaves a man at the altar. And it's because she thinks that she may be in love with a woman, and it's her, like, at first she, like, lives with this woman, and they live in, like, a LGBT community, of, like, houses with a lot of other queer people, and they all have rainbow flags outside their house, and she doesn't want to have them because she's not necessarily proud of who she is or comfortable in her sexuality, and it's kind of her, realizing more about herself and stuff. It's actually really good. More on the adult raunchy side. But a lot of these have elements that are a little inappropriate for kids, but more like PG-13 kind of things. Then here I have Hero by Perry Moore. For some reason I couldn't find this on the Kindle store, so it's here in picture form. This is about a boy, I forget his name because I read this quite a few years ago, but he is the son of these two superheroes. And so, as he starts coming into his powers and realizing that part of himself, he also, starts, you know, discovering more about his sexuality and the fact that, you know, he's gay. So, yes, this, I found it at the library, for, like, really cheap a long time ago. It's blurb by Stan Lee. It's a great superhero book. It's a great LGBT novel and just a coming-of-age sexuality book, you know? Alright, this is already getting a little bit longer, and I still have quite a few books to talk about, so we're just going to try to go as quickly as possible. This is Cut Both Ways by Carrie Morsbrin? Don't know. But this is about a boy who realizes that he's bisexual. A lot of people don't like this book, but I actually really enjoyed it. And I thought the bi rep was good. I'm always looking for good bisexual books because I myself identify as that. And I liked this, and it's about a guy realizing his sexuality, so. And then I have His True Nature by Sylvia Violet, which I think is a really good book on this kind of subject, because it is about a guy who, when he has his 30th birthday, he decides to come out to his family, and they are very homophobic and unaccepting, so he decides to buy this camper and live out in the woods, and he ends up falling in love with a park ranger. So it is very good, and it's very, like, accepting yourself and your sexuality, even in the face of ignorance, and it's really good. It's free on the Kindle store, I believe, still. And lastly, on the Kindle, I have Mad Passion by Naju Rorette. I don't care for this cover, because it's very porn in the words Miranda sings, but, there's literally, like, one or two sex scenes in the entire book, so I don't know why you would advertise yourself as that, so we'll just go here to the title page. And, but yeah, it's about a guy who is a bit older, and he has children already, and he's divorced, and he, is very, in denial about his sexuality when he starts falling for this guy, and then he falls in love and starts accepting that part of himself. Okay, then we've got an uber popular one, which is Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe by Benjamin O'Leary Sands. And this is about Latino boys falling in love, so I don't know what else you really need. But yes, the thing is, the coupling actually doesn't, like, they don't become official until the very end of the book, because the majority of the book is just the boys slowly realizing their sexuality and realizing that they might be in love with one another after forming a really strong friendship. So this is a good one that handles that well. Then there's one that I didn't really care too much for, which is Keeping You a Secret by Julie Ann Peters. This is one of the first, like, queer novels I ever read when I was sort of questioning my own sexuality, and I was like, ooh, a lady loving lady book. I can get down for this. And I really didn't like it. It's about a girl who, at the beginning of the book, she has a boyfriend and everything, and she identifies as straight, and then a queer girl comes to her school as a new student, and she sort of just changes everything for her, and they fall for each other. But I didn't like this book when I read it, because it was when I was questioning my own sexuality, and this girl, after she realizes that she's gay, literally loses her family, her friends, somehow her college scholarship. I think that there was, like, a rep or something that, like, was there and found out and was homophobic or something. You know, her home, everything in her life she lost because she found out she was gay, so it kind of seemed like a, hey, she found out, and then her life became shit. So it really put me in a negative space, and I feel like it was in a time where I wasn't that hesitant to coming out, and then that made me feel wrong. But it is one that I read and I still own, and I plan on rereading to see if I still feel that way, like, come 7 years later, so we'll see. Next one is kind of a different one on the subject, which is Rumble by Ellen Hopkins. This focuses a lot on being gay and religion, and the thing is, I think it explored in an interesting way. The main character, Matt, his brother Luke, at the beginning of the book, he commits suicide because he's bullied so much by these religious people in their school because he's gay. And I think that you slowly see his journey through his brother's eyes and kind of see how it was very innocent and very pure how he was finding out about his sexuality, and that in the face of ignorance, they destroy something that was pure and good. And it's such a good book. It's, like, my favorite Ellen Hopkins, next to Identical. Then, what would one of my videos be without mentioning Cassandra Clare? This Alec, I think that he's very, a lot of people don't like him in this first book because he's very angry and bitchy towards Clary, and I think it's just because he's just drowning in so much self-hate because of his denial of his sexuality. And I think that I liked how the story slowly unraveled in the series, but, you know, it's first brought up and stuff in that first book, City Bones. Then I have Citrus by Saburuta. Could be pronouncing it wrong. This is clearly a Yuri lady loving lady book. This is very angsty, and nobody has actually come to terms with their sexuality in here yet, but I don't know. I feel like over the course of the series, you can tell that that's slowly what's going to happen, and I plan on continuing because I really liked that first volume that I actually read for the booktubeathon. And then the second to last one I have here is the only nonfiction one on this list, and this book is Gay by now Juno Dawson, because she recently transitioned. And this book is basically a how-to guide on being gay. If you are part of the LGBT community and you're kind of like a baby to it, like very new, and you don't really know anything about terms or like sex or anything, and you want to accept your sexuality and be comfortable in it, this is a very good book. It is a very gorgeous book because I love the rainbow, and yeah, and it's also, as it's addressed in the book, a good book for straight people who want to learn more about being queer and being part of the LGBT community, and just, I think it's a good one to read if you're interested in any of that. And I feel like if you don't know anything that's going on with yourself, but you feel like you might be questioning your sexuality, it's a good book for you. And then the last one I have is how this all ties in for my BookTubeathon TBR, because I'm currently reading it. I'm about like halfway through. I read a couple pages of it yesterday, but as an update, I'm on 162, so a little bit more than halfway. So I read quite a chunk of it yesterday, and that's all I read yesterday. So that's my update. But also, this is, as many people know, because it's won a lot of awards and it's very coveted. A lot of these have won awards, like Hero and Aristotle and Dante and stuff like that. And this one, it is about a boy named Simon who is being blackmailed. And basically, if he doesn't help out this guy is going to out him. And yeah, so I think that it's the whole plot of the book is kind of him not accepting his sexuality in a way where he's not out yet, and he's willing to kind of do things that this person demands to avoid outing himself and the boy that he's talking to online. So, yes, and I'm loving this so far. But yes, I had two ideas for the subject when I first heard it, when I first watched the announcement video, and I'm gonna do a different video for the other subject I thought of. I just thought this is slightly more personal to me, because, you know, gay. So, yes, if you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe if you want to see more of my face and my books. Bye.